Hi, news community. Today I'm going to show you a feature which has landed at a 7.2 release, which makes me quite excited, especially for big projects. And this is being able to structure the node types in subfolders in a different folder structure. So let's look how this works in practice. I'm having the demo site checked out here, and as it was before, in your site package you have a configuration folder, and in there we have a very, very long list of node types. So you see actually most content of the configuration folder is inside, are node types. And in big projects, this list can grow and grow and grow a lot. So we have projects with hundreds of node types in this folder. So what can you do now in 7.2 is you can create a new folder and call that node types. Let's say folder, not file. And it's important that this folder is not inside the configuration folder, but it's next to it. So that means it's in the top level folder of your package, next to classes and migrations and resources and configuration. And in there, we can just simply move our files around. Oops. And we see the backend just simply works. Just for demonstration, just to make sure that actually it's really doing something, let's break something here, reload, and you see, okay, there's an error, so that's correct. If we undo it, stuff works again. So actually, this system picks up the changes in the new node types folder. So that wouldn't be exciting as the first step. In fact, it's just a different folder. But the nice thing is that you can now create subfolders as you need it. So that means you can, for instance, create a document subfolder and a collection subfolder. Oops, not in here, but here. And also a content subfolder. And we can move our node types in here. And you can create arbitrarily nested subfolder structures if you want that. And because the system knows that it's about node types, you can easily rename the node types to whatever you like. So that means I personally would just name them in a simple way. So call this one chapter YAML, this one homepage YAML, and so on and so on. So that's an easy way to structure or to give more structure to the big pile of node types you usually have in your projects. By the way, it's backwards compatible, and we won't deprecate the old location. So that means you can, of course, place it still at the old location, and you could even mix that. Of course, in a package, I would decide if I would like to use the one or the other, but technically, this allows for a really smooth migration. So you see everything is still working. So that is quite nice, and I really like that. By the way, this feature is enabled by an underlying flow feature, which is called extensible configuration loaders. And that's quite nice as well, because that means that for your own custom flow packages, if they need a lot of configuration, you can build the same mechanism, for instance. And that's a public supported API, and it's an extensible way to do that. So that's really cool. Awesome. So see you at the next feature.